Hello, fellow YouTubers, it's me again, and I'm back with, can you believe it, another request for my collection update video or whatever. I'm surprised people still find things to request, but at least, you know, they're getting out of the way instead of waiting until like 3 months later, questing shit no one wants to see. But anywho, yeah. As you can see by the title, this person requested to see a review of the Toynami Naraku figure. Now, just so you know, he has terrible balancing issues. Like, look at that pose. That is literally how he stands, and even with the stand he comes with, not gonna work. See that? That's how they actually designed the toy. They gotta be out of their fucking minds. It just falls over like nothing. So yeah, I'm gonna have to be holding him up, so sorry. But anywho, yeah. They based this obviously on his original design, of course, not the new one. I think it's kind of weird they haven't come out with a new one, because that probably wouldn't be cool with all the detail and stuff. But anywho, let's go to articulation. This one has a few. The arms can rotate, just like that, and of course the torso, like all of them can move, pretty much. Which something cool is the hands do kind of articulate here, so you can have him doing a few different poses with his hands. Usually just keep it like that. Same with this arm. Can't really go through 60 because the design, you know, of his clothes get in the way of each other. But this arm can still rotate. The head has kind of a swiveling movement like all the others. He rotates a little well considering, you know, his big hair, but that's about it. He can really just kind of look back and forth. He can't really look up and down. And that's about it. Color's pretty good. They use blue, obviously, and a purple shade. Yeah, nothing really complaining about. He looks accurate, and, you know, just got a little close-up. Just a little details. Pretty good. This is like made of rubber or something, and these are like plastic, so yeah. And not much to say about this toy. It doesn't come with any accessories like, you know, his baboon pelt or anything like that, or even the Samyosho. This is all you get when you buy the toy. And I really don't think it's worth it because, unless you really just want to collect all the Toynamis, you know, there's no point to getting him because he doesn't do much. He just kind of takes up space and just falls down. Let me get the others to kind of compare them in size. Look at Kagome, Inuyasha. What's his face over here? Just gonna size them up. Yeah, I don't have all of them, of course, but I really don't intend to get all of them anyway. These are just a few, just to show you. He is the tallest out of all of them, even though he's kind of hunched over, which is actually accurate because he is the tallest character out of these four. Yeah, that's about it. That's the reveal. I'm gonna give him a 4 out of 5. You know, everything's good. The only thing really that's a knock against him, unlike all the other figures in the series, unless I think for maybe Koga, doesn't come with any accessories, and he has the balancing issue where he just completely falls off. You know, no matter what, unless you prop him up somehow. But yeah, if you want to get all the Toynamis, obviously you're gonna have to get this one. But otherwise, you know, why even bother? It's not really worth it. Unless you just want a Naraku toy, because there really aren't any out there. You know. Oh well. So yeah, hope the person who requested this enjoyed the review, and I'll see you guys later.